When Bhavish said he started doing stand-up comedy, his mom applauded really loud. He stood up finally. That being said, Rahul said a few fundamental things about Catholics. I'm just going to add to that. Jesus invented binge drinking. He knew he was going to die, so he liquored himself up, so he couldn't feel the nails in his hands and all that shit. He called you Bobby Darling, right, Bhavish?
Yeah.
He called.
They call themselves.
He called him.
He called me and he supported.
You're a very participative body.
Oh, yeah.
I want you guys to give yourself like a real fucking
hand of applause.
I said a hand of applause. That being said again,
you're getting free booze. So.
You're getting free booze?
Yeah, you're paying for it.
Who are you sleeping with? Someone's getting free booze here.
Bartender!
Dude! Can I help you?
Indeed. Of course, he doesn't want to help me anymore.
Give him a hand.
I would. He wants you to help him.
No, I would give him a hand. Unfortunately, he's been giving him more than a hand. That being said, you know, the past 10 days I've been extremely depressed because my parents have been out of town. I'm a 30-year-old guy. I live with my parents. You couldn't tell I was 30?
I'm 15.
You're 15?
Yeah.
No shit, Sherlock. Anyways, that being said, you know what? When I was 15, my parents never let me alone. So all the things that you normal people did as 15-year-olds, masturbate in public, you know, whistle at women, get strange women home when your parents weren't around. I've been doing that now. It's very, very stressful. When you're 30 and you have to wait for your parents to go out of town.
He may be talking bullshit, not take my phone though.
That's what he said.
Yeah.
Please.
Actually, this guy is taking my fork and putting it in his mouth.
Who gives the fork?
Ladies and gentlemen, the most disturbing three words you'll ever hear, that dude had my fork in his mouth. That being said, I've not really written any bit for tonight. I was listening to several comics and one thing struck me. None of us has written anything new. Beyond that, my brother had been to Thailand recently, and I told him, you know what?
Bangkok or Pattaya?
Either ways, you'll find what I'm going to talk about next. I wrote a song recently. It's called Thai Transsexual. And I'm going to perform that in the next 30 seconds.
Not on me, please.
I'm not going to perform it on you, man. Do you have a stringed instrument? Let's just say, hello. Let's just say, every man in the room has a woodwind instrument, which he doesn't perform himself. And if you have a stringed instrument, then more power to you. You can pick all night long.
Harp.
Who has a harp? Who the fuck said he has a harp? You have angel string. You motherfuckers have an angel string. Best bit ever. God, I need to be drunk more often. Or as my mom says, you need to stop drinking, son. Either way, if you guys would put up with me for another minute and a half, like my girlfriend does. So here's the song.
That's
is
all?
Called...
Just a minute and a half?
I'm not proud of it, but I face the facts. I am very sound mentally. A picture up in a bar. We took her drive in a car. I took her up to my room. I wanted a bride, she was a groom. Transsexual. My Thai transsexual. I thought that you were a girl. And then you changed my world. That was just the first verse, people. Her boobs were full and nice, but she smelled of Old Spice. I said, I don't swing that way. She said, I'm gonna make you gay. Transsexual. You all know the words by now. My thigh is transsexual.
Thank you. That's my bit for the night.
Nice, nice.